Okay, are we rolling? Okay. Hey everybody, my name is Maya. Welcome to my channel. Today, we will be redesigning the cover of Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire to resemble the trans flag. So, as many of you likely already know, in the month of June 2020, which just so happens to be Pride Month, J.K. Rowling saw it fit to unleash a tirade of posts on her Twitter feed that were quite frankly transphobic and anti-trans in nature. This is problematic for a variety of reasons, the first of which is that the spread of hatred or misrepresentation or misinformation should be condemned at every possible opportunity. Secondly, it was Pride Month of all months, which is a month meant to celebrate the accomplishments and the beauty and the visibility of the LGBTQ+ community. It also commemorates the Stonewall riots, which were led in part by people of color in the transgender community, such as Marsha P. Johnson. And finally, of course, J.K. Rowling has a massive platform, and when that platform is used for something so horrific as this, it can be incredibly damaging, not only on an individual level to the people belonging to the Harry Potter community who are also in the LGBTQ+ community, but even politically, which is frankly quite terrifying, and why I think social media can be incredibly dangerous. So, as a person that is both on a lifelong journey to allyship and a kid who grew up on Harry Potter and considers it to be a core part of her identity, I've had to reckon with all of this and figure out what I intend to do in the future, and I've come up with something that looks a bit like this. First of all, I will no longer be supporting J.K. Rowling or her intellectual property on my YouTube channel. I will also not be supporting her monetarily. For me, this looks like not attending any of the Fantastic Beasts movies. I will not be seeing any of them in the future. I will not buy official Harry Potter merch, and I will not go see Cursed Child on Broadway again, as I did see it a few years past. But on a more humane level, one that has less to do with figures and numbers, I do feel it is in part my responsibility to make sure that people belonging to the LGBTQ+ community who may have considered Harry Potter and the Wizarding World to be a safe space, I feel it's my responsibility to let them know that they are loved and accepted here. And for that reason, I redesigned the cover of Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. I recognize that it's a trivial thing, and that it won't change anything, and that I am a small 5'2", 16-year-old girl living in the middle of suburban nowhere, but at the same time, I constantly am talking about my firm belief that art and literature have the power to inspire empathy, and if my 16-year-old redesigning of a cover can help do that in any way, I'm all here for it. I picked Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire because it features the Triwizard Tournament, which of course features three tasks. There are three colors on the trans flag: light pink, light blue, and white. The dragon challenge can be found on the pink portion of the flag, and I chose the pink portion because pink is generally assumed to be a conventionally feminine color, whereas dragons have been historically associated with bravery and strength and courage, all of which are conventionally masculine traits, so I tried to go for a juxtaposition here. I did the same thing on the blue color by putting the mer people, conventionally feminine, with a blue background, which is a conventionally masculine color. You'll also probably notice that I included a quote on this cover that does come from Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, and it reads, "Come seek us where our voices sound." I included this here because I believe it is so important that we listen to own voice stories and experiences. And that's really what I think being an ally is all about. I think it's about listening. I think it's about seeking people where their voices sound, and their voices may not sound on massive platforms like JK's, but that makes them all the more important. Ultimately, I hope this piece encourages people to listen to own voice stories and experiences, and I hope that it lets people in the LGBTQ+ community know that the fan base of Harry Potter, if not its creator, welcome them and love them and will continue to do so no matter what. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you like the redesigned cover and recognize that art is love and that art can inspire empathy and that people are good and that you, whoever you are watching this, that you are loved. I will see you next time.